بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد. To get this yaqeen in the sight of Allah, we see in different places, different amal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has encouraged us and turned our attention. Whether it's after salah, it's masnoon, read the dua, Allahumma la mani lima aqwit. Ya Allah, what you have given me and what is destined for me, nobody can take it away. Wala mu'tiya lima mana'at. Whatever you have decreed that shouldn't come to me, nobody can give it to me. وَلَا رَوْضَ لِمَا قَضَيْتِ. And whatever your decisions are, your decree will fall. Nobody can stop it. وَلَا يَنْفَوْ ذَلْجَدْ مِنْكَ الْجَدْ. Likewise, if we just ponder after Fajr and after Maghrib, we're supposed to read the fourth kalima. 10 times it's مَسْنُونَ لَا إِلَىٰ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلُهُ الْحَمْدُ يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ. Thus alone, this is not just to read it, but it's to ponder on the meaning and telling you, it's from Allah, control is from Allah, life is from Allah, death is from Allah, benefit is from Allah, harm is from Allah. Let's go back. Surah Al-Fatiha, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. We seek help from you, Allah, and we make ibadat only to you. Let's go back, look at the adhan. The muadhin says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, 4 times in the beginning. Mawlana Yusuf used to explain, he says that takbir in the beginning, 4 times is referring to the 4 elements of the earth. That wherever you are now currently, in whichever spot and position, whether in your business, your profession, how busy you are, we can send the wind like how we wiped out the previous nations and we will wipe you out. If we want, we will send earthquakes through sand. We will wipe you out. We will send through water, floods, we will wipe you out. We will send through fire, flames of fire that will wipe you out. Balls of lightning that will wipe you out. So whatever you're involved in, hayya ala salah. Follow Allah, hayya ala al-falah, you will be successful. He used to give another explanation and say, the 4 takbirs in the beginning is the 4 directions. Wherever you are, north, south, east or west, follow Allah. And at the end, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, above and below means, فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. Whichever direction you look, wherever you see, wherever you are, whether you're on earth, if man you go to the moon, your ibadat, your worship, your following Allah's commands is still compulsory. You can dive in the depths of the ocean, your following the command of Allah is still necessary. Doesn't matter where, when, how, what you are on earth, you need to follow the command of Allah. At-tahuru shatru al-iman, cleanliness is half of iman. Imam Ghazali rahimahullah explains that cleanliness is of 4 categories. And there's a lot of hikmah and wisdom in the words of Janabi Rasulullah to quantify half of iman. He says you need all these factors, then it's worth half of iman. Number one, التطهير الظاهر, that the outward cleanliness عن الأحداث, from outside impurities. So one is napak impurity that shouldn't be in our bodies. Then we have hadas asghar and akbar. So number two, it is mustahab and preferable to be in wudu all the time. So if you're not in wudu, it's a type of hadath. And the third one is that min al janaba, when a person is in a greater state of impurity. So in all forms to be clean externally, number one. Number two, tathirul jawari anil jara'im wal atham. That our outward bodily external organs to be pure and cleansed from all types of sin and masya. So your eyes shouldn't be contaminated with haram, your ears shouldn't be contaminated, your tongue, your mind, all these avenues should be pure. Whether it is a simple video where there is a non-mahram female, whether there is music in the background, any type of masya you should purify. Because once the spot comes, the darkness comes, and each organ gets darker and darker and darker, which envelops the heart, and the heart becomes engulfed with darkness. So there's no cleanliness there, it's darkness. The darkness and the zulm of masya. And a sun is such that when you go into one, it pulls others. Al-khamru jumma'u ithm. Example, alcohol, if a person gets involved, it will get all other sins. A person was given an option, drink alcohol, commit zina or kill somebody. So he thought, so this is the lightest, I'll drink alcohol. He drank alcohol, he became drunk, he committed zina, and then when he realized what he did wrong, he killed it. So guna brings other gunas, and guna sin holds a person, it's like a magnet. Two friends were walking once, they passed a lake. In the lake there was an expressive piece of leather. The one friend said, I'm going to go and jump into it and grab it. He jumped in, he grabbed the leather and he was going to swim out, but he started drowning. So the friend screamed, it's not worth it, leave it, your life is more important. So he screamed back saying, it's not a piece of leather, it's a bear. So he went to grab it, it grabbed him. You grab one guna, that guna will grab you. And not only will grab you, it will grab other gunas with you. Like a pack of wolves. Number three, tathirul qulub anil akhlaqil madhmuma. That your heart should be purified and cleansed from all bad sifat qualities, traits. One from shirk, ascribing partners to Allah, that's the worst. Then kufr, disbelief. Then three, fisk and fujur. That a person must be protected from being a fasik. Ayat al-munafiq thalatha. Iza haddatha kathaba, wa iza wa'ada akhlafa, wa iza atumina khana. When he makes a promise, he breaches it. And if he speaks lies, doesn't speak the truth. And when he's made trustworthy, he's given a trust, he breaches. These are signs of a munafiq. So ulama say also, if a person sees that there's signs of nifaq in him, he shouldn't say, I'm a munafiq. He should say, I see the qualities of a munafiq in me. Somebody was Imam Sayyid Khan Sahib Rahmatullah Alayhi, and he said, Mawlana Ali Asmi, mukhlis. He said, Dune kya kara? He said, Mawlana Ali Asmi was a very sincere, mukhlis person. He said, what did you say? He said, no, I just said he was very sincere. He said, sincerity will only be known on the day of Qiyamah. We cannot guarantee anybody's sincerity. So under the tafsir, huwa a'lamu biman ittaqa, that do not praise anybody excessively. Ulama say, when you think so somebody is pious, you say, not he's a very pious person, in my opinion he's very pious. In my opinion, we should add that on. So we should weigh our words. And the last is, from bad qualities, bad sifat. So hatred, malice, jealousy, greed, all these bad qualities. And good qualities need to be inculcated in its place. Silman kata, somebody breaks a joint. Wa'fu an man zalamak, somebody oppresses you, forgive them. Wa'hsin ila man asa'a ilayk, somebody does bad to you, you do good to them. And the last one is tathirul sir, amma siwallah. That to purify your heart, your internal, that is free of all ghayrullah. To cleanse ourselves.